Yes class, good morning. Today we'll discuss here a new topic, property of the definite integrals. These properties use only the definite integral, don't use in the indefinite integrals. Yes, these properties are here total properties are 7. First property name of this P0 property. P4 property is P0. Name of the first property are P0. What is the P0 property here? A and B, you know A and B the limit of the integration A to B fx dx. You can change, and you can substitute this fx dx in ft dt. Limit will be same, limit will be not changed, but fx dx you can change the any other variable ft dt. Second property. Name of this property is P1 property. A limit same here, A tend to B, A to B. Lower limit is A, upper limit B, fx dx. If you interchange the limit, upper limit you convert to lower limit, or lower limit you can convert, upper limit you convert in the lower limit, or lower limit you are converting the upper limit, then minus sign you can put here. You will put the minus sign, and fx dx will be the same here. So means when you changing upper to lower, lower to upper, then minus sign is come here. Second P2 property are limit A to B fx dx. Suppose you have break down this function in simplest form. A to B is break down in the simplest function A to C. C is the another limit. Then the upper limit and this will be lower limit will be same. The A and B, this A and B, this is A is lower limit. B is upper limit, this is upper limit. Then C the another limit you are taking, the upper and lower you can take, the fx dx plus fx dx. Yes class, next property here, property number 3rd, this is the name of this property here, P3. Suppose limit A to B here fx dx, then A to B, suppose you are adding A to B, A, both limit you are adding here A plus B minus X, then you can use this limit. Then property number 4th here, this is a very important property, to mostly using this property, property number P1 and property number P4. This is a very important property, mostly using this property here. 0 to A, limit here 0 to A fx dx. You can 0 to A f a minus x a minus x dx, then you can use this property also. Second property are important, 0 to 2a f dx is 2a will break down into a, your lower limit is the same but upper limit here break down a and a, the first function is same f dx but second function will be changed 2a minus x. And property number 6, a very important property, 6th property, 0 to 2a fx dx, then limit here, when you divide by this limit, means you have limit here 0 to 2a, that means you are dividing the this number, so the 2 will be multiplied here, 0 to a. When you divide this upper limit here by 2, then you multiply by 2 here. You are dividing by this upper limit, then you are divide by the upper limit, then you write here the multiply by 2. So same thing here. 0 to 2a fx dx, you write here 2, 0 to a fx dx, but condition here given, when value of the 2a minus x equal to fx, then result will be this, but when f2a minus x equal to minus fx, then result will be of this value is become 0. You can direct check this condition, what result of 2a minus x, negative or positive. Suppose result come negative, the value of this function is directly put there 0. Suppose value come here positive, then you result of this function of this, result of this property of this are negative. When the result is negative, then value of this function is 0. A very important property, 7th property, even an odd property. Minus a to plus a, minus limit here same but opposite integers, minus a, minus 2 plus 2, minus 3 plus 3, minus 5 plus 5. So what is the limit? Same thing here 2, 0 to a fx dx. If f is even function, how to check it? f minus f का. Even how to check even fx? F minus x equal to fx. It means function is even. And when f minus x equal to minus fx, function is odd. In this condition, suppose f minus x equal to fx is positive, the function is even function. When function is even, then result is 2 0 2 2 f x dx. When f minus x equal to minus fx, that means function is odd. This means function is odd. When function is odd, then you can result of this part is 0, means value of the integration minus a to a f x is equal to 0. The first value here 2 0 to a f x dx, when function is the positive means even, or minus a to a function f x value is the 0 when function is odd, means this function is negative in this condition. So these 7 properties are very very important property. But property number 1st, property number 4, 6 and 7, these are the very very useful properties. Mostly using are these properties here in the questions. You learn every properties, yes, not only. Yes, class. I'm taking question number 1st, exercise 7.11. By using the property of definite integral, evaluate this integration. This question 0 to pi by 2 cos square x dx. This question you can solve two method. First, you can break down in the simplest form of the cos square x. Then you can integrate and then putting the limit and you can find the answer. Answer will become the same. Answer will be not changed. Second trick here, using the property. But suppose your instruction given you ki using the property, then you will be use the property, not solve this simplest form, not break down the simplest form and simplest form solve. You will be using the property. Without property, suppose you are solving the without property of this question, then you will not get the marks, because here right to solve the question using the property here. Directly given here, condition given here, you will solve this question by the property, not direct solve it, not break down it. Yes. First of all, you will put here solution here. I for integration equal 0 to pi by 2 and cos square x dx. This is the equation first. First of all, every question, suppose you using the property here, then you will be write this given question, you would make the equation first. Second things, you have the one property here. You have the property here. Which property here? 0 to a fx dx. Here 0 to a limit will be not change. F a minus x dx. The property, using this property, 0 to a fx dx, 0 to a f a minus x, using this property here. Now 0 to pi by 2 cos square pi by 2 minus x, pi by 2 minus x dx. Then according this property, 0 to a fx dx equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx. What is the a here? A the upper limit. A here upper limit. Both things same. Then same thing, pi minus x. This using the upper limit here, pi minus x. Or you know, because pi minus theta equal to sine theta. Because this is the first quadrant, the every trigonometrical you see in the positive, but here write the 90, then cos converted to sine theta. The same thing here sine square x dx cos square. Then suppose you are putting the square here, then you write here also square. The cos square 90 minus theta, sine square theta, according to these rules. Then you can write here I this will be converting the equation second. After that, now adding equation first and second. You will add both the equations, left side to left side and right side number function to right side function. The I plus I, this is the 2i equal to 0 to pi by 2 cos square x dx plus 0 to pi by 2 sin square x dx. Now you can taking common here 0 to pi by 2 sin square x plus cos square x and then here dx. Means limit here same 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, then you taking here same one times and dx they are taking common, means sin square theta plus cos square theta result is coming 1. The result here come 0 to pi by 2 only dx, 1 dx. What result come here? 2i equal x, and what is the limit here? 0 to pi by 2. Using the limit pi by 2 minus 0, here 2i, value of the I equal pi by 4. This is your answer. This is your answer. So means when are using the property to mention property, which property are using you here, then writing the you will write in the bracket and then you put the property here and then solve or adding the equation, you get the result. Suppose you are solving, you have not had anything, you are using the property, then you can solve this question in the simplest form also. How to solve it? Means cos 2 theta cos 2x equal to 2 cos square x minus 1, means cos square x equal cos 2x plus 1 upon 2. You break down this form, value of the cos square x equal to cos 2x plus 1. This is your cos 2x plus 1 upon 2. You can write in this form, then integrate it, the result will become the same. This result and this result will become the same. So how to solve here? Integration 1 by 2 take outside, cos 2x dx and plus dx here. So this 1 by 2 here common in both sides. Now when you integrate of this part, the result will come here same pi by 4. Then using the limit also here 0 to pi by 2. 0 to pi by 2. The result will become the same here. The result will be not changed. This is the simplest form. Simple general form of this, you have break down the cos square in the simplest form, then you are integrating it. But for here is not using the property, you are using only the identities, but you are using this property, the according property make the question easier to calculation and to solving and fix any other things. So when you are using the properties, the question will make the easy to solve. Then use this property and solve answer very easily. Yes, note down. Then but don't solve this way, you will solve this way only. Yes class, next question I am taking, question number second here. Same, you will using there by using the property of the definite integral, then solve this question. Here question here 0 to pi by 2 root sin x upon root sin x plus root cos x. Suppose you are solving this question without property, then you will be rationalize this first, then you solve it. But when you are using the property, then you same property you are using the question number first. Yes. Solution start here. Let I equal 0 to pi by 2. Sin x upon cos x. This is the equation first. Always, every time you will write the equation first, question you will write the question in equation first. After that, you are using the property here, you 0 to a fx dx equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx. Using this property here, now 0 to pi by 2 साइन पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स अपॉन साइन पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स प्लस कॉस पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स डी एक्स अकॉर्डिंग दिस वे साइन पाई बाय टू पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स साइन पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स साइन पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स कॉस पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स एंड रूट यार अकॉर्डिंग दिस प्रॉपर्टी यार साइन पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू कॉस एक्स एंड कॉस पाई बाय टू माइनस एक्स इक्वल साइन एक्स बिकॉज दीज आर दिन फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट और फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट एवरी ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियो इन पॉजिटिव एंड देन यूजिंग दिस So now 0 to pi by 2 your root cos x upon root cos x plus root sin x dx this root and this root you will separate not a single root The root sin pi by 2 means cos or root cos pi by 2 means sin. So then, this is the equation number second. Now, adding equation first and second, then what will come here? If 2i equal 0 to pi by 2 root sin x plus root cos x upon root sin x plus root cos x dx same thing here because here root sin x upon root sin x root cos x the LCM part denominator part are same both the equations denominator parts first equation and second equation denominator is the same then you will write the one time this is the LCM or what is the numerator of this root sin x plus root cos x that means LCM is the like form then you write the this form and then we cancel here so 0 to pi by 2 means 1 dx when you cancel it then 1 dx or when you integrate of this 0 to pi by 2 this is equal to 2i What value of the I here? 1 by 2 pi by 2 minus 0 means pi by 4. This is your answer. The first part and second part both having the answer is same. Suppose this question you will solve in the simplest form without any property. How to solve it? First of all, you will rationalize of this. How to rationalize this? Root sin x upon root sin x plus root cos x multiply here root sin x minus root cos x upon root sin x minus root cos x. First of all, you will rationalize of this form. The root sin x plus cos x, what is the conjugate of this? This is the conjugate of, you will multiply and divide both. So you will multiply and divide, then you get the result here. The root sin x and root sin x minus root cos x upon sin x minus cos x. After that, you will be substitute this value, then you will get the answer. Yes, note down it. So this portion you will note down only here. You will not note down this. This is the simplest form to solve. So your complete answer in the I equal to pi by 4. This is your complete answer with help of the property. This is without property. So yes, you note down it. Then next question. Yes, students. Next question. The different type question are very very important question in this type question from the board exam. Same thing using the property of the definite integral and solve this function. Or you know the x plus 2 here modulus function. This is the modulus function bar. You know ki modulus function, when you solve this function, this value come always in the positive. But here function, well, but in this limit, minus 5 to plus 5, in this limit, this function will be, where is the negative value or where is getting the positive value, according this limit. First of all, you will break down this function according the limit, where is the positive, where is the negative. Yes, now start the solution here. Let I equal minus 5 to plus 5 fx plus 2 dx. This is the given question. You know that minus 5, this is the lower limit, and plus 5 is the upper limit. So this function you can break down here. This is the modulus function, you break down in the signum function. But this is the negative value, x plus 2, when is the negative? If x is negative equal to x less than equal to minus 2. Suppose you are using the limit minus 5 to minus 2. This is the closed interval here, minus 5 to minus closed interval. Equal sign means closed interval. Then result will become is the negative. Second thing, when it is the positive, x plus 2 is positive. If minus 2 less than equal to x less than equal to 5. This is the upper limit. This upper limit come in the last and this lower limit come in the first. That means between minus 2 plus 2, this is your third limit. So now you can use this property here, a to b fx dx equal to a to c fx dx plus c to a b fx dx using this property. Using this property, you are break down the limit B or C, and this is the upper limit, this is the lower limit, and this is the lower limit, this is the upper limit. Means when you convert this and this, then you have this and this limit here minus 2, this limit here minus 2, or this is the minus 5 and this is the plus 5. According this property, you will break down this question and solve it. Yes, now start the solution here. Yes, now what value of this? Minus 5 to 2. Value of this minus 5 to plus 5 mod x plus 2 dx. First, minus 5 to minus 2. What function here? Minus x plus 2 dx. When limit are using minus 2 to minus 5 to minus 2, then your function minus x plus 2 plus, when minus 2 to plus 5, when using the limit minus 2 to plus 5, then function your x plus 2 and dx. Then you will solve this question and get the answer. First of all, you will break down this modulus function in the as a signum function, in which function is the negative, which function the positive, in which limit, important things of these two things, in which limit this function is the negative value, in which limit the function is the positive value. Then this limit minus 5 to minus 2, the minus 5 to minus function value is the negative, minus 2 to plus 5, minus 2 to plus 5 value of the function is the positive. Then you integrate it, taking minus sign out, the value of the x square upon 2 plus 2x minus 5 to minus 2, and here x square upon 2 or your 2x are using minus 2 to plus 5. This is your simple integration. Integration of the x here, x square by 2, integration of 2, the 2x. Same thing here. Now using the limit, then for when you calculating here the limit here, very carefully, don't mistake in the calculation. The minus sign outside here, the means minus 2 square upon 2 and 2 into minus 2, then using the minus sign, minus 5 square upon 2 and minus 2 into minus 5. this is the first upper limit here positive, and then minus lower limit is the negative, then minus minus 2. Same thing here, plus 5 square upon 2 plus 2 into 5 minus minus 2 square upon 2 minus 2 into minus 2. Then you get the answer. What value here? This minus sign is outside. So 2 to the 4 minus 2 square is the plus 4, a plus 4 divided by 2, then 2. And 2 to the minus 4, and then minus 4 here come. 2 to the minus 4. Then here 5, 5 is 25 plus 5 by 25 by 2. Minus 25 by 2, and here minus minus plus are 5 to the 10. Minus minus plus 5 to the 10, and then here plus sign, same 25 by 2 plus 10 are 2 to the 4, the plus 4 by 2, the 2, the minus 2 here come, there minus 2 come, and minus minus here plus, the plus 4. What result come here? This and this, you check this 10 minus 4 and plus 2, the minus 2 plus 10, 8 plus 8 outside is minus plus 8 and multiply inside also minus 7, the minus 8 and minus minus plus 25 by 2. This is the come here, or when you calculating the inside the bracket the plus 8, or outside is minus, then minus 8. Here plus 25 by minus 25 by 2 minus minus, here plus 25 by 2. Same thing here, plus 25 by 2 plus 10, 10 towards 4, 40 minus 2, 12. Plus 12, plus 12, and then you subtract it, 25 by 25, this is 25, both are adding, a 10 plus 10 here, minus plus 4, but the answer here comes 29. This is your answer. Very carefully when you using the limit here, when you calculating the upper limit and lower limit, don't mistake in the calculation, otherwise your answer will be coming wrong. You are very careful when you calculate the upper limit and lower limit. Yes, you note down these questions. Every question in the Mulder's function, you will break down the simplest form first. In which limit the function is a negative, in which limit the function is a positive, then you will be writing this form, then you will write this which identity using here. According these properties, you will be mention here and calculate, and you get the correct answer. This is your answer. Yes, note down it.